I got a Minn Kota Ultrex that ain't behaving so well right now. I got full mobility of the steering head from the foot pedal. When I hit my momentary switch or when I hit my constant on, I get nothing from the prop. I cannot get the prop to engage. I ensured that nothing was obstructing the prop. I didn't pick up any fishing line, anything like that. Let's see if we can figure this out. When I go to stow the motor, I get the error beep, the beep-de-de-deep. I had to do a bunch of searching. I got deep into some forums, and it turns out that the most likely culprit is I lost my control board. So we're gonna go ahead and replace that, and hopefully it gets me back in service. Let's go. So really all you need is some very basic tools. Large and a small flathead screwdriver, a number one and a number two Phillips head screwdriver, needle nose pliers, regular slip joint pliers, side cutters, a box cutter, a heat gun or a lighter, and then of course your new control board. First thing I did was I disconnected the power, and by turning the motor I can get the pedal to actuate still. You have one sensor right here, and we need to undo those screws. We're gonna pop that limit sensor out of there. Just use the slack we have in that wire to fit it back down in the base. And since my motor's deployed, I was able to spin the motor all the way by hand. And now I can get to this other sensor. We're gonna do the same thing. Undo the screws. Okay, we get those screws out. Pull a little slack in that wire. And fit that sensor down in the foot pedal. And with the pedal all the way heel down, I can pop my momentary switch out from the bottom. Once I push that out, I can pull it. Make sure my spring stays with it. I'll set that aside. While I'm here, I'm just gonna pry out this little sensor. I apologize for my neighbor's gardener there. I tried to wait him out, but he does about half the neighborhood, so he's gonna be here a while. Okay, once I get that little assembly apart, set it aside, I'll take that sensor and push it down through. Next thing we got to work on is the potentiometer here. Now we're going to have to do that from the underside. From here, I'm just going to tip the pedal on its side, and I'm going to be working on this nut right here. I just need to loosen that up. Now they got the blower going on, so I might have to take a timeout at some point here. Gonna get loud. Okay, before we take a leaf blower break, there's a little E-clip right here. You just need to grab that with your pliers. Just need to grab that with your pliers and pull it off. Then with that E-clip gone, and that little half inch nut undone, you can pull your knob off. You have a spring, there's a washer that fell off in there. Potentiometer comes right out. Okay, while they were leaf blowing, I removed all these screws around here. Then there's two that are different, and these are going to discard because new ones come in the kit. These can be a little stiff, so make sure you don't strip them out. These are the ones that actually hold your control board down to that base plate. So I'm going to get these done, and then we'll wait till these guys are done weed eating and leaf blowing. Okay, now my other neighbor's doing her yard work, so we're just going to get back to it. With that base plate removed, here's our control board. That's what we're going to be replacing. In the lower left here, we're going to loosen up that screw. With that screw loosened up, we can pivot that little keeper out of the way. And now the control board's loose. This is a good time to double check that you do in fact have the power to your trolling motor disconnected. So we're just going to start undoing connections. Looks like we got four wires on blades that you can just pull off with your needle nose pliers. And we have three bullet connectors to get undone. You don't have to be too worried about what goes where because they're color-coded. You got white, brown, and black. So that's two bullet connectors and one bladed connector. Now this connector should have pins in it, so you don't want to be twisting on it. Try and pull straight apart. Just little wiggles. Got a zip tie up here to undo. Got some more bladed connectors on the back side of our power switch. We're going to undo those. And then if you follow your ribbon tape wire, it comes down to the back side of your LEDs, and there's just one screw in there. We're gonna set that screw off. Just for my reference, I'm gonna put that next to my potentiometer dial, because these screws are different lengths even though they're the same thread count. I got a P-clip here, I have to undo that screw. Once that screw's undone, I can feed my momentary switch sensor through. And I can pull that up through the pedal, along with my potentiometer. Okay. This should be our last little harness to undo, and we can get this board out. Now on the back side of it here is a little clip. I'm just going to use the assistance of the screwdriver to get that little clip undone. That's free. And my old board is out. These yard guys are killing me. Okay, yard guys moved a couple houses away, so let's get this thing put back together. While they were working, I put the control board in its place. I secured this corner keeper. I did the two bullet connectors for the white and the black wire. And then I did the bladed connector for the brown wire. Now, something to note here is on your limit sensors, the one for the heel has this little line on it. The one that goes up towards the toe side has no line. So the toe side and the power leads from the switch I put together, and I put them through the little piece of flex conduit. And I have those up with my LED lights off of the ribbon wire. Your potentiometer is gonna feed through that little hole that it came from, as well as your activator switch for your momentary switch for the prop. We're gonna feed those through that hole. My kit came with this piece of shrink wrap. That's gonna go over this connector. I didn't have that originally. Some kits have it, and that's why you might need that razor knife. So I'm gonna go ahead and fit that over. I'm gonna connect these, and we'll shrink it back up. Now it's important that you connect these to where you don't see yellow in here anymore. Then we're gonna fit this right over that joint. We're gonna shrink it up. Once you got that shrunk up, we're gonna fit it back into that bridge. Push her down nice and secure. Okay, we're gonna hook up this little wiring harness here. We're gonna click that in until we hear it click positively. Click, good. We're gonna run the wires for our heel side sensor down. And right underneath this plate, you'll see where it fits through. You wanna fit it through so that it doesn't fall through when you flip this over. I'm gonna take our toe side sensor. I'm gonna fit it through its little hole. Then I'm going to take my leads for the power switch. This is a good time to take one of the included zip ties. Fits right under here. It's going to hold that wire run in place. Now, we take this set of ribbon wires. We're gonna roughly route it in the place it's gonna go. And then you're gonna wanna line these LEDs up with the tubes that they fit in. Once you got that in place, you can go ahead and put the appropriate screw back in. So on the back of the instructions that come with it, there's a wiring diagram. I would encourage you to look at that, because not all control boards might have the same wiring needs. So I'm just gonna start at my bottom left corner and see what we have going on. That is the battery negative. So I come over here, this is coming from my battery negative. Now right above it is the motor negative. That's this one. Now continuing counterclockwise, I'm gonna be at the 12 o'clock position. That is my battery positive. So that's gonna be my black and red. And the only one I have left is my motor positive. I'm just gonna confirm. Yep, motor positive. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna clean up my slack in these wires. And then I'm going to try and dress this ribbon wire so that it doesn't get folded, crimped, pinched, or otherwise damaged. That's good. I'm happy with that. Now I'm going to take my base plate, fit it back in place. Now the first two screws I'm going to put in are the ones that go into the back side of my control board. Right here. Because those are going to be the hardest to line up. New ones came in my kit. So I'm going to go ahead and use those. I can peek in there and see that I'm not quite lined up right. So maybe I can use my screwdriver to get me in place a little better. Gonna start that one by hand. Let's see if I can't line that guy up a little bit. Okay, once my control board is connected to my base plate, I'm just gonna do four corners to hold this, just in case something goes a little off. Now I can flip the pedal up on its side. Now I have my momentary sensor. I'm gonna go ahead and feed that through its hole. Then I can grab it and feed that wire back through its housing. And then I can push it back down into the housing. My starting position on that is gonna be just like a 32nd of an inch, maybe even a 64th of an inch above flush with the bottom. I'll push it down in place. Next step is getting this potentiometer in place. Okay, that's in place. Okay, so this potentiometer, the post on it is in the shape of a D, which means if I turn it all the way counterclockwise, I'll be in the off position. Get that washer to sit there. And then I should be able to line up off on my knob with my indicator. I should be right there. Yes. Now I just have to refit that E-clip like that. Okay. Good, I'm just gonna put that on midway. Okay, we get that wire back through the P-clip. We'll refasten this screw. Okay, now we'll flip our pedal over and we'll start working on these sensors. I'm putting these limiting switches in. You want the text up, you want to be able to read it. So one side's smooth, that side goes in towards the pedal. The part that has the raised sensor, that's going to stick up. Okay, our toe side limiting switch goes in. Want to be able to read the text, the raised side goes up. Now we're going to replace our momentary switch pad. We'll put that spring in place. Spring's up. Good test. Okay. Okay, I had a little camera glitch yesterday and I lost the end of the video, but here we are back out on the boat. We got everything put back together and we're powered up out of the cradle. We're going to hit our momentary switch and
She works. We're back in service. All right, hope this video helps you guys get back in service too. Go out and get them. Tight lines.